Yo, what is up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Slice of Shonen. I am your host, The Cloudy Crow, and today we will be reacting to Vinland Saga episode 20. Now, in the last episode, we kind of got to take a dip into Thorkell's past, where we got to see his relationship with Thors and why he came to admire Thors so much. So way back, I believe like 15 years ago, 20 something years ago, he was fighting on the battlefield next to Thors. They were just destroying everyone that they came across. And then eventually we came to the part in Thor's life where he had Ylva, and he began to kind of change his mindset towards war and fighting. And he decided that he wanted to focus more on his family instead of fighting. And so we get to the part where he's fighting on the battlefield. They were on the boats and stuff, and then he faked his death by jumping into the water and kind of never coming back up, seemingly. So fast forward about 2 weeks from then, and everyone is kind of hosting the funeral for Thor's because they think that he's dead. And then Thorkell actually ends up bumping into him while he's trying to flee. And then Thors pretty much tells him that he's become a true warrior and he doesn't want to fight anymore, and he wants to leave with his family and kind of start a new life. And Thorkell just couldn't comprehend that. He didn't understand why he'd want to leave the battlefield. And so, of course, he swung at him. Thors just completely countered it and knocked him out in one shot. He was flat on the ground, unconscious, and when he woke back up, they were gone, and he never saw Thors again. And so from that moment on, he was pretty much just contemplating what it means to be a true warrior, and he believes that he can find that answer through fighting Thorfinn. So Thorfinn and Askeladd come up with a plan where Askeladd pretty much tells him that the only way for him to beat him is to exploit his weakness. And so they go in, Askeladd kind of distracts him by putting a gleam in his eye, and while he's partially blinded, that's when Thorfinn jumps up and kicks him straight in the temple. Now, one of you guys told me in the comments section that the same place where Thorfinn kicked him is where Thors punched him, and that's why it's his weak spot, which I didn't even realize when watching, so if that is true, then that's insane. And then after that, Thorfinn jumped on top of him, gouged one of his eyes out, and it just got so crazy from there. Thorfinn looked like a wild animal trying to take him down. But Thorkell accepted defeat, and then soon after, Canute came through, told everyone about his plan to fight the king and take back the throne. Thorkell jumped on board, Askeladd's on board, we're on board, everyone is ready to go and meet the king and take him down once and for all. So, if you guys are excited for the episode, make sure to leave a like, comment your thoughts on the episode down below, and subscribe for more Slice Shonen content. Make sure to check out the Cloud Crowd Discord, link will be in the description, and also consider supporting me and my channel through Patreon for as low as $2. But with that all out of the way, let's get right into this episode. Alright, so this is the part of the episode where you guys will be grabbing your source videos. If you do not have one of your own, I will have one linked in the description. It'll be the first link that you see. So all you gotta do is click that link, bring up the video, and get ready to sync it with me. Because we'll be starting episode 20. I believe we only have 4 more left. In 3, 2, 1, go. Alright. Let's see how they end this. Because I believe there's more that goes on after this, right? Like, this isn't going to be the end of Vinland Saga once we get to episode 24. The manga still continues past that, I believe. But I wonder where they're going to end the anime. And Floki, long time no see. Ooh, seems like he's kind of shook. Ooh, he's actually shook. Now we know. Canute's outright tamed the beast. Oh, we're already here! Dang! And Thorkell's got the eye patch. Yeah, why do you look so surprised, buddy? Askeladd, what's up, bro? He is so shook, man. Ooh. Oh yeah, sure. Canute is not buying that garbage. Dang. Now you work for us, buddy. Go notify the king. Yep. All right, dude. I bet he couldn't see any of this coming. Like, first he hired Askeladd to go kill kill Thorfinn's father, Thor's. And now Thorfinn and Askeladd are together. They're not necessarily allies. They're kind of like, I don't know, they're like business partners. Only with Askeladd because eventually he plans to take him down. And then on top of that, they sent Canute into battle so that he'd die in the war that Thorkell was in. And now Canute's leading an army with Thorkell on his side, Askeladd at his side. Like, if they wanted to, they could take down Floki right now. And he knows they're going after the king. So I wonder, what's he gonna do? And honestly, I want to see what Floki's capable of because clearly, like, he's the leader of a pretty formidable army, the Jomsvikings, so clearly he has to be a good fighter. But I don't know, we haven't seen anything from him so far. Because he's hired everyone to do his dirty work for him. I wonder though, if we like put him on a scale next to like Canute and Askeladd and everyone, where he would fall. Oh snap, they plan to take these guys down. He's like, sign me up. An assassination would be best, huh? And Harald. I have a bad feeling. Harald just might come home early. He's like, I'm only here for Askeladd, all right? Like, you want a beating, kid? All you have to do is ask. Askeladd is pretty much his uncle at this point, though. Dang. And he has a grudge against God. All right. Dude, I like the way this sounds. Dang. But then the only question is, what happens after when their time is up on Earth? But still, man, if I lived during this time and he gave that speech in front of me, I'd be like, sign me up, dude, I'm ready. A paradise on Earth sounds awesome. Especially with so much war going on around. And look at this dude. He's got liver spots, crusty lips. I mean, he has no idea that we're trying to take him down. Twenty of them. They're trying to take him out. Yep. Oh, look at the. How did Thorfinn know, dude? What a dude! How did he know? He said there's 20 of them waiting. Got assassins posted. Thorfinn, he's ready. Ooh, and that's what he looks like. This whole time, we've never seen his face until this point. And Askeladd's completely shocked. He's gonna call up the archers. Yep. He's not this cowardly little kid anymore. Ooh, and we're about to do the same, buddy. You better buckle up. We're about to cut you down. And the power got to his head. Yep. So if you don't have a plan or a goal that you want to drive all of them towards, then you're going to get lost in the power. Here it comes. Oh snap. That's the signal. Dang, man, he had a ton. What's Canute's plan now? Things are definitely looking bleak. This is looking like the Thor situation. Oh, this music though. Oh, let him know. Dang, man. Asklet's great at negotiating, dude. He just might pull himself out of this. Yep. The one covered in ashes. Dang, he already knows of him. Ooh. Oh! He's heated. And this aura around him. He is not playing. Dang. Those words definitely struck a chord. I know Asklet wanted to slit his throat right then and there, but we have to wait. Keep your friends close and your enemies closer. So we gotta pretend like we're working with them. Dang, let him know, Canute. And he's already, man. Dude, this is so interesting, man. He knows that Askeladd's a threat. Like, even though it seems like we have this big plan that is working so far from what it looks like, seems like the king's no idiot. Is that the priest? Oh, that's him with his hood down. Oh, he shaved too. What? That man is clean cut. He's 23? But that's not a no. Yeah. Who is this clown? Gunner? Or Gunnar? What is this dude's problem? Just put your hands in your pockets. Oh, they both have the they both have the same bald head. I can see the family resemblance. Dang. This man's world is shattered. He's changed, yep. He's grown. Taking a leak. He does look fishy. Thorfinn's out here training. Dang! I'm telling you, man, this kid's got talent. Ah. Not these two. And his brother. Oh, man. I forget. What is that called? Man, there's like... I don't know what it's called, but it's like when you go through something traumatic and it kind of like reverts your mind back to when you were a child, or like, I don't know, like to a time before the trauma happened or something. I don't know. I remember this happening in Baki, though. When, dang, I don't even. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You guys know what I'm talking about. If you know, you know. I was getting sidetracked for a second. Dang. Yep, start a family. Dang. That's for the best for him, though. Dang, and that guy's selling slaves? Leave! Is he still looking for Thorfinn? Man, so much happened in this episode, dude. Holy. Alright, so that was the end of Vinland Saga episode 20, and we finally made it back home to Canute's home. We're right under the king's nose where we want to be. It seems like, well, of course, we want to become king. We know the plan. We're trying to take out the king, but there's no evidence to show that we're trying to kill him or we're trying to assassinate him or anything. So the king doesn't really have much justification to kill us. Whereas, on top of that, the king is a pretty smart man. He knows not to let his guard down and just be like, "Oh, welcome back, Canute," and just be chill about the whole situation. He knows that something's up, but he's playing it smart. He's kind of playing some 4D chess right now, thinking steps ahead. And so instead of acting now and killing Canute, he's gonna wait, hold off for a bit, see how things play out, probably pull some strings underneath the scenes, but other than that, not too much happened. So if you guys enjoyed the episode, make sure to leave a like, comment your thoughts on the episode down below, and subscribe for more Slice Shonen content. Make sure to check out the Cloud Crowd Discord, link will be in the description, and also consider supporting me and my channel through Patreon for as low as $2. But with that, I'm going to head out, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Have a good one.